Great to see you. You're on the cusp, on the build up to a big event in London. How are you feeling? How's camp?
Yeah, feeling good. Feeling strong and healthy and excited. So excited. Only 16 days.
I know. Well, it's not long since you last fought in summer. I know it was May, but it seems like it was fairly recent. A dramatic finish. How do you reflect on that performance against Janae Harding? Because did it bolster your confidence to come from a difficult situation and get the win?
Yeah, there was a lot of like setbacks at that camp, and that fight week was extremely difficult. You know, I was recovering obviously from COVID. I had shoulder surgery, I had a popped SC joint, I had a knee injury. I couldn't even straighten my knee. So the biggest win for me was being able to walk out into that cage. Like mentally knowing what I went through that week, even the night before, and all the circumstances surrounding that fight, like that gave me so much confidence in how far I wanted to push myself, you know, physically, mentally, and in every way. And then obviously, you know, it was great to get a good finish against such a good opponent.
Yeah, and the way it happened as well, it seemed like the momentum was with her. She's trying to strike down at you, and the up kick, and then ultimately the choke. I mean, that was pretty impressive stuff. Was that something you'd worked on, or was that something that I guess comes with experience in the cage?
It was just probably experience in the gym, just doing rounds and rounds with the boys, and always being in bad positions and fighting back out of bad positions. Like, it's a fight to fight. People are going to have some good moments and bad moments. She caught me with a nice kick and rocked me, and I was able to capitalise on that. So, you know, I was definitely, you know, obviously delighted to get that finish, and especially, you know, being able to submit her. She'd never been finished before. And, yeah, I took a lot of confidence knowing that I always believe I can always get a win no matter what kind of circumstances happen in the fight or on the lead up to the fight. So I was definitely proud of that.
How important is it to stay calm when you're in those situations, when maybe you're facing a bit of adversity? Is that the key in MMA, particularly when you're on the ground?
Yeah, because obviously anything can happen. You can plan, drill everything, and then you can go in and just like the most crazy. You can be put in these bad positions, You can get caught with a punch in the 15 seconds in and fight the whole fight rocked. You know, so yeah. You just have to prepare for that, and that's why you drill so much in the gym, and we train so hard, and it's why it makes MMA so exciting, because anything can happen.
Yeah, it certainly can. How's the body now, and with the COVID, how long was the recovery from that? Do you still feel the effects of it, or is it fully out of your system?
No, I don't feel the effects of it now, but I did for months after I had it. Like, and it never affected my breathing, which is lucky because I had asthma, but like neurologically and my strength and my fitness and so many different areas, like total exhaustion in that whole camp, you know, and gyms being open, gyms being closed, is the sessions on today? Like, there was a lot of setbacks, but everything's a bit more calm now, thankfully. Yeah,
It must have been hard how to gauge the intensity when you've had COVID, I suppose, if it's not clear exactly how affected you were to know what pace to go at in the gym in the build-up to that last fight.
Yeah, and not only that, it's like nobody knew. Like, there was no advice from any doctors, anybody you spoke to. There was no, like, ways to people are telling you how to recover, and everybody had different symptoms, and it was definitely scary, definitely glad of it, and it's over and done with. Like, but yeah, it was a tough, you know, camp and fight week.
Well, it's good that you're feeling better now, and it's great ahead of this fight. How do you assess your opponent, Jessica Borger? Because she's had ups and downs, hasn't she, in her professional career to date. What does she bring to the party in terms of her main assets?
Yeah, you know, she's a similar style stylistically to me. She likes to close the distance, catch kicks, get in a clinch and take it to the ground. She's got heavy ground and pound. She jumps with submissions fast, and I need to be switched on, because where she likes to put the fight, that's where I like to put the fight. I think, you know, one mistake and you can be in the wrong position, and, you know, I just need to be sharp, switched on from the moment I go in and fight my fights. I've just been focusing more on me this camp rather than, you know, overthinking opponents and stuff. I just want to, still don't feel like I've even shown any of my potential yet, and I just want to just kind of have that confidence going into this fight that I want to be my fight, and I want to push the pace and put it where I want to fight.
Yeah, does that come off the back of you're on a 5-fight win streak, of course, since your debut? You've responded great to that first loss. Do you feel that is bolstering you each time you go in there?
Yeah, but I still feel that I have so much to show and so much to grow. And, you know, every fight I have is on massive stages. Like, I've never had time to just mature and develop as a fighter. I'm always main card, main event. She was always like big steps and big audiences and high pressurized environments where it's, you know, it's you need to go in feeling the weight of the world on your shoulders, whereas I've never just been like relaxed, been able to go in and flow and just fight the way I know I can. And I know I'm very fortunate to have all these opportunities, but it's just about me believing in myself and just relaxing when I go in there. And I feel like that's going to happen on the 1st of October.
Yeah, it should be a big occasion. I mean, how excited are you? You talk about the headlining, but your co-main event to Michael Venom Page in London with fans. It should be a fantastic night, shouldn't it?
Yeah, I am so excited for that fight. I remember watching the first fight and I can't wait to see it. When I seen that they were main event in London, I was so excited. So to be co-main event is such an honour. It's such a, like, it's a big platform for me, big stage for me to shine. I just believe I will on the night. You know, I work so hard, I train so hard, and I just want this to be a kind of make a statement.
It's good for your fans to be in this time zone, isn't it? I know you've probably got fans all around the world, but for fans back home from Belfast and Dublin, it's nice that they can watch it at a sociable hour.
Yeah, exactly. I don't even know. Like, some people knew the last fight, some people didn't. It's nice, and it's going to be in London. My family are coming over. All my close friends are going to be there. It's going to be just such a good occasion, especially it's the first card back in the UK and Ireland since COVID. So it's so happy I'm going to be on it. And I've always wanted to fight in London, so I'm going to going to be on this card, especially. I think this is the most exciting card they've done in London.
Yeah, it looks great. What about, is there an event in Ireland as well later this year? Was there talk of you possibly being on that, or is that just something
yeah. 1 or 4 weeks after. So when I win, I'm going to get the mic and be like, guys, I'm fresh.
Are you?
4 weeks.
would you do that? Would you? Is that, are you just sort of what, tape the training between? You could do that between the four, no, 4 week date.
No, I definitely would. I don't know if they would let me, but I would.
So it depends on the fight, does it? I guess how much it takes out of you.
Yeah, hopefully I'll be in now unscathed and go again in 4 weeks.
Yeah, because that would be special to be in Dublin, I suppose.
Yeah, definitely. You know, obviously I'm really looking forward to the Dublin cards. It's got James and Peter in the main and Comey, and both brilliant fights. Can't wait to see them shine as well. Such a, you know, Dublin's the best and the best crowd. It's going to be so nice to have fans back in the Three Arena.
Yeah, it certainly will. I wanted to ask you something as well, because obviously your career is going great guns, but I think you posted on social media and we talked previously about the challenges of being a mother and an athlete, but I think your daughter gone to secondary school now? It's a bit of a landmark.
No, she's at P7, so she's doing her transfer test.
Oh, okay.
So no, she's not in big school yet.
But is she 11, is that right?
She's 11.
Oh, okay. So it's probably slightly different in Northern Ireland. But is that a landmark for you, that sort of just that you're sort of reflecting on the passage of time and the fact that you've got this far and she's grown up this much since you became a mum?
It's so scary. I don't even want her to go to big school. I want to take her out of it and just homeschool her. And so innocent and like not sheltered, but she's like got such a nice spirit and way about her. I want her to stay like that forever.
Yeah, and it must be a challenge as well, I guess, for what it is for a parent anyway, isn't it? Because you have that duality of wanting to provide for your child or your children, but you also want to spend time with them. So I suppose, do you feel that the more she grows up, that tension?
Yeah, and especially because, you know, I'm a lot of her like life so far I've been in fight camps. to make her life's easy. So I remember I worked like from when I was 14, like 3 jobs. Like Isabella just comes in, she has an easy life. I work and fight and work so hard, so she has a nice comfortable life, so I'll do all the hard work, she can just relax. She always comes in from school and says, "Mom, I'm just having a wee relax." It's like, okay, go on ahead.
Yeah. is it nice to have that caring role on away, because fighting's quite or being an athlete is quite self-focused, isn't it? You look at your own nutrition, your own training. I suppose having a child to look after in a way takes you out of yourself.
Yeah, and it's like I do have a great support system in my family and my friends. Like they make it possible for me to fight and to do what I do, you know. But yeah, it's nice. Isabella's definitely, you know, being able to look after her and care for her, and she's just such a asset. Like she's such a great child. I'm so blessed to have her, and she's such a nice person. Which she's definitely my biggest accomplishment and achievement is her, who she is.
How are you gonna win, do you feel, this big matchup in London? You want to do it quick so you can get back and fight in Ireland. How do you see it going against Jessica Borga?
Yeah, but I do think she's gonna prove she's gonna be a, she could bring a tough test on the night. She's strong in the clinch. She doesn't give up easily, and it's gonna be a good fight for me. But I think that I'm gonna dominate standing and in the clinch. She'll feel when she gets in a clinch with me, or she tries to take me down, she'll feel my strength, and I'll be one step ahead in those positions. So I am that's where I like to be.
Leah, pleasure to speak to you. Thank you very much, and good luck in the upcoming bout, and we hope to see you in action again after that soon.